Hello friends, welcome to KSP Academy. The last class we already discussed what is the working principle of hydropower station. In that each block we already explained. In that one of the important concept I'm trying to elaborate what actually it is. That concept is called as a water hammer effect. So what do you understand by a water hammer effect? Is nothing but generally in this through the dam, the water will flow through the pressure channel, go back to the wall post. Through this penstock, the water will hit a turbine. The turbine will convert kinetic to mechanical, mechanic to electrical. The process keep on going on. Regularly, the potential energy by which created by dam is converted into electrical energy. The process is going on. It's a regular process. Whenever, please focus on video. Whenever there is a fault on the generator or there is a fault on the penstock, fault on the generator or there is a fault in the penstock, therefore what you have to do is you have to close the valve hose. You have to close the valve hose here and valve hose here. Whenever you suddenly close the valve hose here, then there is a chance to get a forward and backward movement of water, and there is a backward and forward movement, high pressure water will create in the penstock. Due to this high pressure, the penstock will get start vibrating. Then there will be chances that penstock will go to be damages. It will blast, it will blast, it will take place. To secure the high pressure, that high pressure will create a forward backward movement in the penstock is called as a water hammer effect. To reduce this water hammer effect, we have to use a separate equipment is called as surge tank. What surge tank will do means, this high pressure or low pressure of water, which will send back to the surge tank, so water will keep on increases in the surge tank. When there is a high pressure, that extra pressure, high pressure of water will again go back to like bypass into the surge tank. Surge tank is a bypass valve. When our high pressure will take place, water will go into the up, it will store it temporarily. When our pressure will decrease, that water level will keep on down, go back to the turbine and go back to the. Therefore, this water hammer effect which will be developed in the penstock, by which it is protected by a surge tank. Whether at important point, water hammer effect developed in penstock, developing penstock protected by surge tank or four base. Surge tank or four base. Generally, which will occur basically in medium and large power stations, that is above 100 kV. Due to this, the surge tank is protected. Basically important, developed in penstock, protected by a surge tank. So take care about the water hammer effect. I hope very clear this water hammer effect. Thanks for watching. Keep continuing for the next videos.